Hey guys, it's Chris. Are we alone in the universe? Does time even exist? Or are we living in the Matrix? Here are 8 of the craziest scientific theories out there. Now, which one do you believe? Number 8. The Law of Infinite Earths. If you've lived long enough on this planet, you've probably asked yourself, are we alone in the universe? It's one of the biggest questions we ask as humans, but there's actually a grander question that has been asked by scientists. Are we the only universe out there? There are many theories about what lies out there, but one that is very crazy depending on how you look at it is the Law of Infinite Earths, or the multiverse theory. It's called many other names, to be fair, but that's one of the most popular. The basic principle of this theory is as such. Our Earth and all that surrounds it is one universe. However, on another plane of existence, there is another Earth that is different from our own, and it has its own universe. Many supporters and believers in this theory speculate that on those other Earths and planets, things are slightly different, creating a new world as a result. For example, on another Earth, the Civil War might have been won by the South, completely changing the course of history. Or a meteor might have struck the Earth in modern times instead of missing it. And on it goes. Some even say that for every single decision we make, there's another Earth where the opposite decision was made. Thus, the Law of Infinite Earths. You might feel that you've heard this before. And if you're a comic book fan, you likely have. The multiverse theory is a very strong part of Marvel and DC comics, but it's not just a comic theory. It was introduced to them because of scientific research on the subject. And who's to say they're wrong? We can't exactly scan all of our universe, so how can we know for sure that there isn't another universe on another plane of existence? Number 7. Time isn't real. Those three words likely caused a lot of you to be confused. Weirdly enough, though, they were uttered by a man named Julian Barber, who is not only a respected man, but one who is an expert in physics and quantum gravity. As such, he wouldn't make such a statement if he didn't have at least a way to explain it. According to his theory, time is something that humans and animals can perceive, but in fact, doesn't actually exist. So how does that work? Well, it's a little complex, but I'll try and word it out. So don't think of time in the concept of seconds or minutes or hours. Rather, think of it like a number line, going from 1 to 100. Mathematically, all the numbers are their own entities. And according to Barber, those numbers are the points in our lives, or as he calls them, the nows. These nows are independent of one another and exist separately from one another in a non-connective way. So in math, the number 2 comes before 3, but 2 doesn't evolve or grow into 3, it's just 3. Get it? Many other people in history, including philosopher Nietzsche, have said things that support this theory. So if it's true, our universe just got a lot more complicated. Number 6. The Doppelganger Theory. Here's a popular one that a surprising amount of people believe. So when you were born, you were told you were unique, that your DNA, or the God that created you, made you for a specific purpose, and thus gave you your unique look. This is true, your DNA does make you unique. However, there are some who believe that elsewhere in the world, right now, there is another you. Not a clone or a lost twin, but rather someone who matches your face, and your DNA even to a certain degree. This is the doppelganger theory. To be clear, this isn't an Earth 1, Earth 2 thing. Thank you, comic fans, for getting that reference. This is on one Earth, two people looking like each other without being related to each other. What's truly weird is that on certain levels, we know that this is possible. Think about it. In your life, you've likely met two people and go, "Wow, you look kind of alike." We've all done it, and some people think it's amazing how two people can look so close to one another. But in truth, it's all genetic. Our genetic code defines who we are in height, weight, and look. So two people looking the same is not impossible, it's actually entirely probable. The rub is that because of how big the world is, you've likely never met your doppelganger, if they're out there. Number 5. Ekpyrotic Universe. The Big Bang Theory is one of the most accepted yet controversial beliefs on how the universe itself was created. But because not everyone believes it, there are those who have other ideas for how the universe was born. One of the more crazy ones is the idea of the ekpyrotic universe. And what is it? Well, to best explain, I want you to imagine a thin piece of paper, one that you are holding in your right hand. That paper is our universe. Now imagine you picked up another piece of paper in your left hand, and then held these pieces of paper as close together as you could without them touching. This is the ekpyrotic universe. And by this theory's notions, the way our universe was born was when these two universes actually collided, releasing a massive amount of energy that created the universe. But technically, it didn't just create the universe, it reset it. By that token, the universe can be reset an infinite amount of times. All it would take is for these two universes to collide once more. Now, the Big Bang Theory doesn't sound so odd now, does it? Number 4. Fermi Paradox, or Rare Earth Hypothesis. Are we alone in the universe? This is the question that has plagued many a human mind over the generations. For ever since we discovered that our planet was not alone in the universe and that the Earth wasn't the center of the universe, the idea of finding life on other planets was infinitely appealing and a little terrifying. True, there have been alien sightings over the years, but this is beyond that. This is a factual acceptance based on irrefutable evidence. Is alien life out there? There are two scientific theories out there that say there are not, which may not sound crazy, but when 77% of the Earth's population believe in the concept of aliens, it does raise some questions. The first of these is the Fermi paradox, where a scientist calculated that between the time had in the universe and the likelihood that there is life on other planets, that there should have been alien contact made by now. Yet there hasn't, not officially anyways, which begs the question that Fermi asks. Where is everybody? The rare Earth hypothesis is the belief that though there is microscopic life on other planets, human life is restricted to Earth. Not because of a god, but because of evolution. We are quite literally one in a billion or trillion. Our race is the only one that we know of to surpass the bonds of basic evolution, and thus, we are alone. Number 3. The universe is a computer. To be clear, this isn't a Matrix reference. Rather, there was an Oxford professor who proposed that the universe at large actually works on the fundamental level of a computer. It's actually a rather intriguing notion. For on a simplistic level, he's not exactly wrong. For in his theory, he notes that everything we see, everything we do, is a basic function, like a bit of information. And not unlike bits of information, we give yes or no answers that by definition affect other systems, which in this case would be the other people in our lives and the cities we live in and more. Further adding to this, when asked what the universe is computing, Vlatko Vedral noted its own dynamic evolution, which is another thing that a computer can do. It evolves, especially since there are people now making quantum computers, which can do just that via its own programming and makeup. It may sound flawed, but that's what makes it so intriguing, because what if it's right? Number 2. Time travel. From Star Trek to Doctor Who to 12 Monkeys to Back to the Future and everything in between, time travel has been the source of many great sci-fi stories. But in the real world, where our concept of time, alongside the technology we have, is a bit more rigid and fixed, it seems like something that will remain in the world of fiction. But someone didn't tell that to the people who believe that time travel isn't just real, but that it's possible. The theories surrounding time travel are infinite, including one by Stephen Hawking, noting that if it was possible, why wouldn't time travelers have shown up already? Another famous scientist noted that time travel might only be possible in terms of cyclical movement, meaning you can only move through your own timeline, because that's the only events you've experienced. Then, as many writers and Time Lords have noted, time is a web that you can travel through if you have the right technology, like for instance a TARDIS. In some ways, time travel actually breaks numerous laws of physics, while others argue that the concept is just a loophole in them. The other possibility is that there may be time travelers among us, but they know the basic rule of time travel. Don't do something that'll interfere with the future. If it is possible, though, that'd change the way we'd look at everything. Number 1. We are living in the Matrix. The Matrix trilogy is known to be one of the most visually stunning film series of its time. But more important than that, it proposed a very dark vision of the future, where humanity isn't bred for the most part, but actually grown by machines. These machines then plug the consciousness of the human mind into a computer simulation of a world that the humans believe is real. They live their lives, and when they die, they're discarded. Simple as that. But what's not so simple is that there are people, very credited people, who think that we actually live in the Matrix right now. It's easy to dismiss such people, but they actually have some interesting proof of this. First off, if we do live in the Matrix, we wouldn't know it unless we knew what to look for. Not unlike how Neo thought everything was very real until Trinity and Morpheus pulled him out. Furthermore, like a computer, the world would have limits to what it could do and show, such as not having aliens or finding a finite size for things. Sure enough, aliens haven't officially appeared on the planet, and there is a known amount of something that can exist, called the Grizin-Zaspin-Kuzmin limit, or the GZK limit. This is the smallest a thing can be in the universe, which is based on a mathematical principle for how small a pixel can be on a computer screen. Are there signs all around us? Some people think so. And if we're all plugged in, the question then becomes, how do we get unplugged? Well, thanks for watching, guys. What did you think of these scientific theories? Can you believe some of them? Or do you think maybe they're a little too radical? Let me know in the comments below, be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on World List.